Okay, so good afternoon, everybody. So in this video, we are going to introduce financing cycle. Then we are going to discuss your long-term liability ninyo and bonds payable as discussed in your SIM ninyo. This video will be very short lang, because the audit of financing cycle is not that what you call this one, not that complicated, unlike other cycles, your investing cycles, your revenue cycles, and expenditure cycles, which are more complex than your long-term than your financing cycle. But for your financing cycle, very simple lang po yung ating ano natin, discussion natin, because it has a very simple lang din na internal control over financing cycle natin. So we shall start. So financing cycle, no, just like other cycles, it forms or it is a very important cycle in a company, because financing cycle natin is our way for the company to acquire funds or resources for the entity. Anong ibibili natin ng PPE? Ano ang i-invest natin doon sa mga shares at bonds if wala tayong ano, if wala tayong pera, 'di ba? What are the money, no? What funds are going to use to purchase our inventory as part of our expenditure cycle para makabenta tayo, which is part of our revenue cycle. That is why, although very simple lang po yung ating financing cycle, but it forms a very big part in the operations of the business. So, financing cycle is an acquisition of funds and resources for the entity. We have two sources of funds under financing cycle natin. So, we could use long-term liability or equity, no, as our source of funds. As for long-term liability, we are dwelling with the creditors. It is the creditors. It is from the creditors our funds came from. On the other hand, para sa equity naman, doon sa mga owners galing yung funds and resources that will be used for the entity. Now, for this video, we're going to focus on our long-term liability, on our creditors. But before we go specifically sa long-term liability, let's discuss the common feature of your tawag nito financing cycle. This is the common feature on the internal control, no, of your financing cycle. Pag sinasabi kong common feature ng internal control ng financing cycle, these two features are applicable to long-term liability and equity. Okay? So ito yung mga internal control, ito yung mga common internal control policies and procedures for both long-term liability and equity. And these are the features which are very prominent na tinatanong talaga sa mga questions, not only sa mga reviewers, but ultimately doon sa mga sa board examination natin. Okay? So first, authorization. Since this is financing, no? This is financing, at hindi naman tayo utang siguro na ng long-term liability or equity for 10,000, 'di ba? This long-term liability, or when we want to produce funds through equity, this money that we are intended that we want to raise are large sum of money. Kaya kinakailangan ng authorization. Very important po yung authorization coming from our board of directors. If we want to increase our shares, number of shares for us to acquire new shares, or if we want to increase our bond indebtedness, if you're going to review your law, your anong tawag noon, your law on partnership and corporation, it needs a specific authorization from the board of directors. And ikaw as auditor, if you want to examine whether the increase in share or the increase in bond indebtedness has been properly authorized by the board of directors, titingnan mo ngayon sa minutes of the meeting. Okay? So again, remember this internal control is not only for equity, but this is for equity and the bonds. So this is applicable. Mamaya, when we go to your SIM, you will encounter the same internal control features because these are common. As long as covered siya by financing cycle, this common feature or internal control applies. Now, for the use of independent trustee, no, as part of a good internal control talaga, as part of the good intern part of good internal control, we advise our client to use financial institutions, no, financial institutions. And that financial institution shall be an independent trustee for their shares and for their bonds. Okay? Meaning, yung financial institution ngayon ang mag-i-issue, 'di ba? Mag-i-issue doon sa third party, doon sa bonds technically para sa magiging secretary ng company. Okay? Hindi mismo si company yung magre-record at mag-i-issue ng bonds at ng shares, but they have an independent trustee, commonly financial institution, that will hold and that will execute lahat ng mga kinakailangan, no? Kinakailangan for the, what to call this one, for their financing cycle. For example, sa bonds, kung meron kang independent trustee, so si independent trustee, no, siya ang mag-i-issue ng bonds sa mga bondholders, sa purchaser of bonds upon your approval. 'Di ba? Tapos kung magbabayad ka ng interest, ikaw company, you're going to give a check. Bibigay ka ng check sa financial institution at si financial institution na 'yung magbibigay ng mga tawag nito, magbibigay ng mga interest, no, on the bondholders, on the individual bondholders. So para sa secretary, para this lang middleman. Okay? The same thing pagdating sa shares. So pagdating sa shares naman, the same ang mangyayari po. The independent trustee, the financial institution, they'll be the secretary, the middleman, they'll be the one to issue shares, no, upon the authority, upon the approval of the company. Tapos kung merong dividends, sila din mag-distribute ng dividends sa mga stockholders. Okay, so these are the common features for the internal control for our financing cycle, both for our long-term liability and for our equity portion natin. Now, let's go specifically sa ating bonds payable natin. So, ano yung audit objective natin sa ating bonds payable when we audit your long-term liabilities, in particular bonds payable? We need to ascertain the adequacy of the internal control structure policies and procedure over long-term liability. Dapat yung internal control is sapat, no, for the company. Second, verify that all long-term liabilities are recorded and are proper and are recorded properly. And also, interest expense is correctly computed and all other contractual obligations are satisfied. Remember, 'di ba, meron yang contract, 'di ba? So, meron din yang mga anong tawag nito? Meron yang mga certain provisions within the contract na dapat ma-meet ng client mo. For example, nangutang siya sa bangko na let's say 1 million. Tapos nakalagay doon sa kontrata na pag hindi nila na maintain ang kanilang debt ratio ng 40%, magiging demandable yung utang nila sa bangko. Okay? So that thing, dito yan papasok, no? Dapat na-satisfy ng company, di natin titingnan kung nababayaran ba niya yung utang, but most importantly, titingnan din natin if nami-meet ba ng company yung contractual obligations as stated in their contract. And number four, to ascertain that the disclosure is adequate for your long-term liabilities. Ito yung sinasabi ko kayo na sa inyo. Internal control for long-term liability, authorization by the board of directors, kinakailangan siya because that's part of the bylaws and bylaws of the company. It requires an approval, no, from the board of directors. use naman of the independent trustee, di ba? Any company large enough to issue bonds and be able to find a ready market for the securities will almost always utilize the services of a bank as independent trustee. The trustee is in charge with the protection of the creditor's interest and must continually review the issuing of the company's compliance with the provision of the indenture. Look at this. Para sa secretary, as I mentioned now kanina, di ba? They maintain the records of the name and the addresses of the registered owners of the bonds. Sila magkakansel ng bonds. Sila mag-i-issue kung may change sa bond ownership. Sila ang mag-redistribute sa payment at sila magbabayad sa principal payment kung mag-mature na yung bonds. So, bad ng secretary, sila para silang middleman. Okay? Binabayaran sila ng company. May fee na binabayaran si company sa mga financial institution which stands as independent trustee para gawin tong lahat. And alam po natin na very strong yung internal control within those financial institution because they are highly monitored by the government. Kaya by using an independent trustee, this is a good feature already. Plus points na yan agad, no? Na maganda yung internal control over long-term liability. Okay? And last is the interest payment on bonds and notes payable. Alam pa natin, di ba, na dapat yung ating pag-determine ng interest na going to pay for the bonds and the notes payable must have a proper, no? Must have a proper and extensive, no? Handling of those interest payments also. Okay. So, ito yung mga working papers. No? Kinakailangan natin, no? Kumuha ng kopya ng kontrata. Their indenture. Bakit po, sir? Because, gaya na dito, sa contractual obligations. Because we need to notice, kinakailangan natin ma-make sure that the company is following what are the contractual obligations under the contract. Okay? Analysis of ledger accounts of notes and bonds payable. Itinan natin ngayon kung meron bang changes sa notes and bonds payable, meron bang nabayaran, or meron bang bagong notes or bonds payable. And of course, if it is bonds payable, more likely meron yung discount and premium amortization as well as our interest natin. So ito yung mga audit procedures for our long-term liability. Of course, presentation and disclosure. So kinakailangan, we need to make sure natin, di ba? Of course, that the contractual provision are met, no, by the company. Kasi again, sa most of the contractual provisions, if not met, will require the company will make the debt immediately demandable. Kaya hindi na siya magiging long term, hindi na siya magiging non-current, but hence as we present that one, magiging current na siya. Kung hindi na na-meet yung ano yung nasa kontrata nila. Okay, and supporting documents include notes and loan agreements, bond indenture, and lease agreements. Now, for the existence and occurrence, okay, ang ating kino-confirm, I want to make this clear. We are confirming, no, the confirming party, our common confirming party are our independent trustee. Tinatanong natin, we send confirmation to the independent trustee, no, about some information about the bonds. And we do not, as auditor, we do not send, no, we do not send confirmation letter to the individual bondholders. Enough na that we send, that we ask confirmation, send confirmation sa ating tawag nito sa ating independent trustee. No? Confirm the creditor, the transactions, and the compliance with the contractual provisions. And also, as part of our confirmation, no? Example, diba, pag may bonds, commonly may sinking bond, may sinking fund dyan, diba? Way back sa ating cash, di ba? May mga sinking fund which is related or being established for the purpose of the sinking fund. So, at by confirming also third party, confirming the bank about their utang, it will also reveal na meron pala silang sinking fund din na related pala sa bonds. Kaya it will also be helpful as we audit also your cash. So connect-connect silang lahat. Okay? Review the cutoff to determine the transactions recorded at the end of the year are recorded in the proper accounting period, no, especially no atong tinatawag na accrual, no? Accrual of our interest. So very important thing to notice or to ano to make sure na na-comply natin 'yan. Obtain an analysis of the long-term debt, discount premium and related interest accounts. So that to be able to ano, so that to be able to make sure na kompleto yung ano, yung mga transactions that happened during the year. Now, ito yung pinaka-common na ginagawa natin as auditors talaga, no, when we want to audit long-term liability, we perform analytical procedures by comparing, di ba, by looking or by looking at the relationship between the bonds payable and our interest expense together with premium and discount of on bonds payable. Kasi alam po natin, pag tataas yung bonds payable, tataas din yung interest expense, no? At the same rate, no, it has also relationship sa ating premium and discount. Diba? And premium and discount, alam po natin that premium and discount has a relationship with interest expense. Premium decreases interest expense. Discount increases interest expense. Remember, therefore, importante talaga yung ating pag-perform ng analytical procedure. That is the most common, no? The most common procedures, no? Auditing procedures we do for our long-term bonds payable, okay? Performance of analytical procedure on our bond premium and discounts as well as in our interest expense natin, okay ha? Most common performance of analytical procedures. Okay? For the bond sinking fund, again, we do confirmation. Okay? Because it is only on by confirming sa third party, no? Confirming sa ating bond indenture na malalaman natin na meron palang bond sinking fund. So, confirm tayo with the bond trustee natin. And lastly, for the valuation, oh, syempre, to make the valuation correct, so kinakailangan dapat natin, no, na tama yung pag-amortize natin ng premium at discount po natin. And all of na kinakailangan natin na i-disclose, dapat na-disclose as well. Okay? So, I think that will be all for this theory for our long-term liability natin. So, thank you and God bless and stay safe.